mom was in the field, and my mother had gone to market, and I was mending clothes, and I admit, I was daydreaming about Joseph, and I was betrothed to Mary. But suddenly, I was startled. I looked to the doorway, and there stood a stranger. I thought, he must be seeking my father, and I would have told him to go, but he stepped through the door and spoke to me. "Hail, woman, richly blessed, the Lord is with you." Who was this? What did he want? He didn't seem dangerous in a threatening way, but he didn't seem altogether safe. He was quite different. And then I realized, this is an angel. But what did he mean by calling me a highly favored one? My family was nothing special. We were poor, humble people. We were from Nazareth, not Jerusalem. And everyone from Nazareth is considered to be somewhat of a hick. But the angel didn't leave me much time to think. He continued, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for the Lord is, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will call him Jesus." The angel then foretold that this son would be the Son of the Most High, that God would give him the throne of David, that he would be an eternal king, reigning forever. Were all the old prophecies coming true at once? I had often heard scripture read in the synagogues, and many times I had listened as my father spoke with other men in the village about the coming son of David. And our family did trace its ancestry back to David. But how could any son of mine sit on his throne? The throne of David descended Solomon, while my family tree goes back to his son Nathan, who was never king of Israel. So if my son were to sit on David's throne, that right would legally have to come through another family. And then I thought of Joseph, the man I was to marry. He was a descendant of David through Solomon. Would he be the father? But what the angel told me didn't make me think this baby was coming from Joseph, so I asked, how can this be, since I'm a virgin? I think Gabriel almost smiled. I wondered about that later, and I came to believe that he was amused that I would have a problem with such a small detail. Here I had been told that God was going to break into history and set up a king on the throne of David who would be his very son and rule forever. Surely the greatest marvel of all time. And all I could do was wonder how I could get pregnant. But even that detail was a wonder beyond understanding. The angel explained that the Holy Spirit would come over me and that the power of God would encompass, embrace, and enclose me, and that in the shadow of his overarching glory, I would become pregnant. What a wonder. Certainly, the birth of Isaac to Abraham and Sarah in their old age was miraculous, and the birth of John to Zacharias and their cousin Elizabeth was a miracle. But the birth of my baby was more than miraculous. He would be born in my virginity. He would be conceived without a human father. He would be human and divine. He would be the Son of God and the son of a humble Nazarene girl. So I said to the angel, "Let it be done to me according to your will." You know the rest of my story. Everything the angel announced to me came true. Even that first Christmas night, as I was cuddling my newborn baby in my arms, I raised my voice in wonder. There in the stable, we received a visit from some shepherds. They too had encountered an angel, in fact, a whole host of them. And they were there to see my baby. When they left the stable, they were glorifying God and praising him for all they had seen and heard. They just couldn't keep quiet. They told everyone that the Son of God had come, that the Messiah had arrived, that there was a Savior. I, on the other hand, was less demonstrative. The others were shouting and praising God for this first Christmas night, but I kept all these things and pondering. God